Live streaming is viewed 6 times more than the average pre-recorded video. In today's economy, there is no better way to get your message out and to get heard with your audience. I'm Amber Vilhauer, and during today's Fast Track video series, this is one in a 4-part series talking to you about how to grow your market share with viral live streaming. But today's episode is going to focus in strong on what you need to do as the host to deliver for the best possible experience. And if you would like more information on how our team at standout.live underneath my company, NGNG Enterprises, which stands for No Guts, No Glory. If you would like to know more about the standout.live division and how we can set up live streaming for you and execute all of the nitty-gritty details so that you can just show up live, speak, and do your thing, then go to standout.live for more information. If you are turning on that camera to go live, whether you're going on Facebook, LinkedIn, YouTube, Periscope, Twitch, Insta, Twitter, there are things that you must know as a host in order to do a great job and get the kind of result that you're going to want and need to get the most market share possible. Today's video is going deep into the host experience, meaning what do you have to do to deliver the best possible experience for your viewers and get the highest amount of conversion after the fact. Conversion could look like a high amount of engagement inside of the live stream or even into the replay. A conversion could look like an increase in your follower count on your social media channel. A conversion could look like the number of people that go back to your website to join your email list or to buy into any of your products and services. The way that you create the experience as a host will have a direct impact on your conversion overall. There are really 3 things that you want to focus on. And we're going to talk about your warm-up, the tech, and the actual delivery during this Fast Track episode. If you have any sort of a mastermind or a group community that you can share this with to improve how other people are delivering their message, please do so. I want to help as many people as possible here today. Let's dig into the actual warm-up. If you're doing any sort of speaking or video recording or live streaming, having a proper warm-up routine is actually a really critical component to having the kind of delivery and experience and outcome that you're ultimately wanting out of the time spent in delivering that message. Most people don't have any sort of a warm-up routine, except possibly trying to talk themselves off of the ledge and not wanting to do it in the first place, depending on how experienced you are. But a proper warm-up routine, just to simplify it and kind of get you to jump in with both feet, is number one, you want to get yourself into the right mindset. What does that mean? Well, definitely want to get rid of any sort of mind chatter that you have about your fear or your nerves or what you're going to look like or what you're going to sound like or how people are going to perceive you. When you have that experiencing happening up here in your thoughts, you're not being present to the moment. You're certainly not in real service to your audience because you're making it more about you. This isn't about me. This is about you right now. And so reminding yourself to be in that awareness, be in that seat of presence is going to be really important for you to deliver the right kind of experience that people are going to appreciate. Also, remember why you're doing this to begin with. What is your intention? If you can think ahead to the outcome of the live stream that you're about to create, whether you're doing a solo live stream, meaning that you're going live by yourself and maybe you're doing some sort of a workshop or you're delivering some sort of a message or a teaching component, or perhaps you're using live stream in a more interactive way. You're either getting a client to come in and put you in the hot seat, you are profiling one of your clients as more of a case study experience, or perhaps you're interviewing some expert or influencer in your industry, related industries. There are all kinds of ways that you can use live streaming. But you want to remember the intention. Why are you doing this to begin with? And if you can think ahead to the viewer that's sitting on the other side of this experience, and what are they thinking? What are they feeling? What do they need to experience to feel like this was really a valuable use of their time. And when you can show up in that mindset, you don't have to worry about a lot of the other things. The second thing I want to share with you in your warm-up routine, I want you to write this down. Elevate 20. This is something that I've remembered from early days. You won't hear anybody else talking about this. Elevate 20. What the heck does that mean? Well, you have to really elevate your energy when you are recording video, or especially when you're doing live streaming, because however you think you're coming across, I want you to take like a dial tone, like a meter in your mind, and dial it down about 20%. And that's how people are actually experiencing you. It's true. So what I have to do before I'm getting ready to do pre-recorded video or live streaming is I have to get my energy levels up by about 20% more than feels almost natural to me, because you're trying to transfer that enthusiasm into a camera, a digital screen, through my camera, into your screen lens, and then into you. That's an incredible barrier that you're trying to get through just to be able to have a deep personal connection with your viewer on the other side, right? So I actually had to dial up the intensity and the energy and the excitement in my body so that I can transfer that all the way through that barrier to impact you so you feel it on the other end. So I want you to remember, elevate 20, write it down, put it on a post-it note right in front of your camera. I want you to crank those energy levels up. Now, what I'm not suggesting that you turn clown-like, that you embarrass yourself or that you're silly or overly dramatic. That's not exactly what I'm saying. Instead of you trying to downplay it, maybe down here, I want you to raise it up to here. I don't want you to be that lion or that almost like a lioness, something that has more energy, presence, strength. You're grounded. You're ready to transfer that enthusiasm and make an impact on the other end. So remember the Elevate 20 trick. Let me know how it works for you. And the last thing that I want to share in this first phase here of the warm-up is that I want you, when you are live streaming, I want you to think about one person in your mind that you are delivering this message for. I've done tons of live streaming to big audiences, thousands and thousands of people before. And when I'm doing it, I speak to one person in that audience and I deliver all of my messaging. It's very conversational, it's personal, it's intimate to that one person. And when I do that, it becomes more anchored in me, and then it comes across differently to the viewers, and you're going to have that impact on the whole. So you want to have definitely a proper warm-up routine to get your head straight, to prepare to deliver an amazing experience to your audience. Okay, that's the first step of the host experience. The second thing I want to talk about is tech, though. How do we get your tech right? We do a lot of live stream coaching for clients. We have a whole done for you service where we'll come in, we'll set up an entire live streaming series for you. Think about it like a podcast, but it's live stream through multiple online channels. And then on the back end, we repurpose all of the live content to optimize it for YouTube and turn it into a blog post and do your social media and your email marketing. All our clients have to do is just show up and talk. And then we do the rest. Now, this is all coming out of advice that I give to our clients over at standout.live. So it's coming straight to you here today. When I do an audit or consulting about the tech side of things, it's not sexy talk. Clients don't like love talking about that, but it's a necessary part. Number one, it starts with having a good quality camera, and you want it to be eye level. Notice that I'm not angled down and I'm not angled up. I'm dead center with this camera lens. That's actually a really important thing because I want somebody to feel like we're having this one-on-one conversation, that I'm able to look them straight in the eye. That's a really important part of transparency, trust, developing personal connection. So I have an HD Logitech webcam. I have it sitting on a little stand. You could buy like a desktop table stand on Amazon. I think between the stand and the webcam, it was maybe $60 or $70, but it's a really crisp webcam experience, which is important. Now, I am personally recording this right now using Zoom, believe it or not. They have an HD setting that I tick on. And when I'm doing live streaming, I use Zoom as well. So I personally use Zoom for absolutely everything. Having a quality camera matters. Having a backdrop is also going to matter. And notice my positioning vertically on this camera. Notice that my head is very close here to the very top of the screen. Sometimes you'll see people doing videos where it's like most of the screen height is just in backdrop. You want to be able to have a strong presence inside of the frame. So be thinking about where you actually stabilize yourself within the screen. Where are you doing your eye movement here? And then you just want to invest in a quality microphone that's picking up on your sound. Don't have your microphone visible here in the screen. That looks a little silly. So I just have it resting right here in front of me to pick up my audio sound. And then you want to make sure that you have good lighting. I'm very blessed in my office. This is natural lighting. I have no lights on right now in my office. In my previous office environment, I had to have two of those ring lights. Just go to Amazon and Google ring light. I would have two ring lights coming in an office before that. I also had to have like a backdrop light come in. I had terrible lighting in that office. It was really unfortunate. But I've had clients that will actually post up downstairs in their living room in a nice chair with a nice looking backdrop. Anything that is going to get your audience to feel like they're having kind of this personal conversation with you, that's usually going to lend itself best in the camera. Just a few things to be thinking about in terms of the tech, but this is all a part of the host experience. How are you delivering this experience through your live streaming? Because yes, you are on camera and it is live and it all does matter. It all adds up to this outcome, just like a math equation. How are people going to view this experience of you, and are they willing to tell other people about it? Just things to think about. The last thing within the host experience that I want you to really consider every time before you go live is your actual delivery. Earlier in the warm-up phase, we spoke about the Elevate 20. What does that mean again? Crank up that energy and that strength being grounded by about 20% more than you think is normal to get through that barrier, because people are already absorbing you at about a 20% deficit. So you want to crank that energy up. And now moving forward, I literally want you to imagine that energy, that it is energy. Sorry if you don't like that word, but it's energy output coming through you, through that camera lens, into the other screen and into your viewer, where you are giving them hope, energy, inspiration, motivation, confidence. You're helping to dispel any guilt or shame or fear or nerves or whatever else it is, depending on your industry. Your energy, your presence has to be strong enough to combat a lot of different things getting in your way. So this delivery becomes really important. Something that I also need to coach, usually more my male clients with than females, is don't forget to smile. It's such a simple thing, but a lot of people could smile a little bit more. Smiling is the ultimate sign of really transparency, trust. It's like I'm showing you my whole face, right? And it's really warm, it's welcoming, and it gets other people to smile and feel good, right? You can't look at somebody who's genuinely smiling and be super grumpy. Like, it's impossible, right? And don't you want to uplift your viewers and make them feel good? Because for crying out loud, they can walk out their front door and look around and feel bad about any number of things, right? So when they come to you, let that be their moment of relief, release, joy, excitement. They're learning, they're connecting, they are transforming, you're helping them, right? So these are all things to remember in the delivery, but smiling can be an important thing. Knowing when's a good time to take a beat can be an important thing. I have to constantly remind myself of this because I love just pouring information out. You've probably noticed this about me. Sometimes I feel myself like I'm a fire hose just shouting out information at you in a really positive and upbeat way. But that beat can be a relief for viewers on the other end just to absorb what you just said. or even repeating yourself if it was an especially important point. Remember earlier in the warm-up phase when I was talking to you about the Elevate 20, and I took a couple of beats in there. I repeated it a few times. I asked you to write it down because that was important. That's a signal to you that that's an important moment. So don't forget to take beats. It wouldn't be a bad thing at all if you took a post-it note or a piece of paper and wrote down these tips that I'm giving you onto a note card. So just before you go live, you're thinking to yourself, did I warm up? Did I do my Elevate 20 exercise? Am I only talking to one person? Does my lighting sound, look good? Where's my frame at? And it's like a little warm-up checklist that you write. Don't forget to smile. Right? Don't forget to put energy through the camera into the other end. Transfer that enthusiasm forward. Have a beat every once in a while. Also remember, when you are interviewing somebody as the host in your live stream, I want you to be taking some notes if that helps you. But when I'm listening to somebody as the host and they're talking, I've just asked them a question, I actually take down notes on keywords. Things that I think might be like interesting follow-up questions. I'm not furiously taking notes because it's most important that I'm listening. Listening is one of the most important gifts and traits and skills that we can really start to develop, especially if you're going to be doing more live streaming, because you want to ask really interesting follow-up questions and you want to repeat some of the wisdom that your guest has just shared, right? You're reiterating, you're sharing with the audience what you hope they took away from that answer. And then you're asking really smart follow-up questions. And you're literally just writing down a few keywords. And when I'm live streaming with somebody, again, you could go to NGNG Enterprises on Facebook. You can check me out all over YouTube. I stream live to multiple channels, so go back and watch any one of my episodes. But you'll see that I'm kind of jotting down a few keywords and notes. And while I'm listening intently to what that person is saying, and I'm connecting with that person, and I'm thinking, oh, I love that he just said that, or oh my gosh, I'm so glad she just said that. And that's what I'm thinking. I'm reacting to the conversation, and I'm still transferring enthusiasm. Even when I'm sitting there listening to my guest, I'm still transferring this enthusiasm. We're in the middle of this flow and this dialogue while I'm kind of taking notes on things that we could talk about next or teaching moments that I want to reiterate in the end. And once the guest stops talking, I take a beat. I recognize them for something that they said that I thought was so on point. Sometimes I will then direct my attention to the viewers and asking them to comment on what they thought was especially exciting out of what the guest just said. And then I'm adding a follow-up question, or I might add some of my own value first as well, because it's important when you're doing an interview on a live stream that it's not just you asking questions and you're not getting involved. They want to hear from you too. You can add in your own value. It's a bit of an art because you don't want to be like a runaway train with it, but you want to add a little bit of value, then go back and ask your follow-up question to the guest. And you'll start to see, if you go back and really analyze the way that I've done live streaming, you'll start to see it's this flow that happens where you're listening, you're responding like with your enthusiasm, even though you're not talking. Taking away some keynotes here. When the guest is done, I recognize them for something they said. I direct my attention to the viewers to get them to engage now and be a part of this experience. Then I'm coming back with my own value and then asking a follow-up question. And that's just beautiful flow and harmony. Your first time out of the gates, you might not be able to do so many moving parts, but that's the whole point of me sharing this information with you. And this is just a speck of the depth that we go into with our standout.live clients as well. If you want me to go back and audit some of your live streams or have some sort of a consult to talk to you about how to be a little bit more finessed, a little bit more polished or casual when you're live streaming, then I'm absolutely open for that conversation as well. But I think as the host live streaming, whether you're solo live streaming, you're inviting guests or clients or audience members into this experience with you, what I want you to remember, first of all, is to keep an experience. Have a warm-up routine. Look at your tech. Make sure that you're really ready to go live. Then I want you to really think about the delivery, smiling, beats, being concise, how you're managing conversation with the person that's with you, how you're engaging with your audience, what kind of call to action do you want to give, not just at the end. You'll see if you go back and analyze some of my live streams, I'm adding regular calls to action to my audience members throughout the entire live stream experience. And so as you can tell, I've been doing live stream for many, 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 many months. And that's why I'm so happy to offer this series to you on our Fast Track series about how to grow your market share with viral live streaming. And this is just the first of four different trainings inside of this series. On upcoming episodes, we're going to be talking about the speaker experience. When the guests come in, what do you need to know to prepare those speakers so that they shine for you? They promote for you. They're deeply a part of this experience. They're committed to it. How on earth do you get that to happen? Well, I'm going to teach you in an upcoming episode. We're also going to be talking about the customer or the viewer, the end person experience, because, you know, they're essentially watching you having this conversation with somebody, or they're watching you live, but how do we get them to feel like they're right here in the middle of the conversation with us? There's a science and an art to that. And then we're going to wrap up the series by talking a little bit more about how do you actually set up your own series and what are all of the moving parts and some of the things that nobody else is talking about when it comes to how to get that live stream to go viral. And if you want to cut to the chase, you can head on over to standout.live for more information or to set up a call to talk about how we can grow your market share in your industry using this fantastic tool of live streaming. If you thought this video was helpful, be sure to subscribe to YouTube so that you are notified when future videos like this become available. You can always head over to ambervilhauer.com. We'll put that up on the screen. Get a copy of our pricing menu. See all of the things that we're about. We do websites and marketing and bestseller book launches. It's an honor to be a part of your journey. I hope you get into live streaming today. There's no better way to get your message out. And until the next time, just remember, no guts, no glory.